Hi, my name is Piper. I'm a naturalist here at Formar Nature Preserve and Arboretum, and today we're going to be talking about wasps. Paper wasps get their name from their homes that they build out of a pulp-like substance that they make from scraping wood off of things like benches, the side of your house, a wood pile that you might have in your backyard, and they chew it up and mix it with their saliva, which creates a paste, and then using their mandibles, they flatten it out and they make a house that looks kind of like this. Other types of wasps actually make their homes out of this paper-like substance as well, such as hornets. But many people confuse yellow jackets and paper wasps because they look very similar. As you can see, paper wasps are more black and have a thinner body compared to the yellow jacket, which has a fuller body and is mostly yellow. Yellow jackets actually make their homes underground, and a lot of people call them ground bees. So people confuse their homes, but paper wasps are the only ones that make the homes like this. Every winter, all the wasps in the nest die off except for the queen. She overwinters under pieces of bark or in little crevices, and in the springtime, a group of queens will start a whole new nest. They never go back to their old nest, so if you find one that is abandoned, there will be no wasps that are trying to come back to it or currently living in it. Recently, a family found a huge paper wasp nest up in their attic, and they brought it to Formar. Getting a closer look, you can see the lines of the pulp that they deposited in sheets to make their nest. Right here, where my thumb is, you can see the different layers that they added over time. In each of these layers, there are hundreds of cells where the paper wasp queen will deposit eggs, and they will grow there into larvae. To protect their brood, or their cells full of eggs and larvae, paper wasps can even suck up water that has accumulated from rainfall, and they can spit it outside of their nest to protect the babies from drowning. Another way they can protect their brood is they can secrete a chemical around the base of their home, so right around here, that repels ants that might want to eat the eggs or the larva, and this chemical keeps them away, so they put it right around the base of the nest to repel ants from eating them. Some paper wasps will even sit around the opening of the nest, such as right here, and then will fan their wings really fast in order to circulate air throughout the nest to make sure that the wasps that are wandering around inside don't get too hot. Paper wasps are actually omnivores, so as an adult, they will drink nectar from flowers or juices from fruit that has fallen on the ground. And worker wasps will bring back insects, like such as caterpillars, to the other wasps in the nest, as well as the larvae. For this reason, they are great as a pest control for agricultural farms. They will eat all the pests that would normally eat the leaves of the plants that farmers are trying to grow. So wasps are actually great to have around.
Let's get a closer look at one of our paper wasp nests. This is an example of a larger paper wasp nest. The size depends on the size of the colony and when they started the nest. If we were to cut this open, you'd be able to see that there are many layers and the nest is built from the inside out. It kind of looks like rings on a tree trunk. Here is the opening of the nest. This nest appears to only have one opening, so this spot on the nest is where all of the wasps will exit and enter. Here's another example of a paper wasp nest. As you can see, this one was built around a tree branch, but they can build them hanging off of any type of structure. Many people often see them on the sides of their houses. Paper wasp nests often start as an umbrella-shaped honeycomb structure like you see here. They then build layers and layers of the paper pulp around the nest to protect it, because this is where the queen bee will deposit her eggs, in these little honeycomb cells. These different colored lines that you see show the different materials that wasps have collected to build their home. Some could have been from a park bench, some could have been from the side of a house, and other materials collected from a wood pile that are different colors. This paper wasp nest was found in between the siding of someone's house. So the rectangular and more flat shape that you see compared to our other examples are due to the constraints of where they were building their home. In order to keep adding layers of these honeycomb-like cells where the eggs are kept, paper wasps connect the layers by building these stalk-like columns called petioles. This gives the nest plenty of support and structure so that it doesn't collapse on itself.
Get away, right? right-of-way at Genesee County Parks. For more, visit GeneseeCountyParks.org.